Let us commend ourselves and each other in all of our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. Thank you.
Christ our God.
Thank you.
mighty is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
God speaks in the plural form. There's three angels that came and visited Abraham and Sarah, which is the icon of the Trinity that we have above our royal gates, is is in remembrance of. So there were these events in human history where God was beginning to sort of put out those little breadcrumbs, that prefiguring or foreshadowing of the revelation that was going to come, the incarnation of Jesus Christ, and at his baptism in the Jordan, Jesus in the waters, the voice of the Father bearing witness, and the Holy Spirit in the form of a dove, alighting upon our Lord Jesus Christ. And we continue to remember and celebrate this feast day, this manifestation, the showing forth of God, because we know that this began Jesus' public ministry. He went from the Jordan into the desert for 40 days, and then began to pick up with that great preaching of John, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And not only is the kingdom at hand, as Jesus tells us, it's within us. Right? So we know this truth and we proclaim this truth. We blessed waters this past week. Some of the holy water is there. I moved the spot for the holy water. So if you go back there and see an empty table, don't worry. I just moved it up here to make it a little bit more convenient for people to gather some of the water to not only have a drink this evening or any other time when you're here in church, but also to bring some of it for the sanctification of your homes and your workplaces. Of course, if you allow me and would like, I would be happy to come and do a house blessing as well. The sign-up list is in our parish email. But today we're also honoring the memory of the holy martyr Polyeuctus, or Eftus, or Ectus. I don't know how to say it right. I'm sure that there's some Greek speaker that can tell me that I'm slaughtering it each and every way that I just said it. His story isn't one that's really well known to many of us, but he's an important saint in the life of the church in Armenia. He is the proto-martyr of Armenia. He died in the 3rd century. And as we heard in the hymns, he was a soldier. He was very affluent. He was married. He had children. He was a person that had everything that you could possibly want at that particular time. But there was, as they like to say, a God-shaped hole in his heart. And when he was introduced to Christ, that became the most important thing for him. And he witnessed to the Lord Jesus actually going and taking an imperial decree in the middle of the city and tearing it up for everyone to see. And for that, he ultimately gave his life for the sake of the gospel. His name, which is very fascinating, Father Dan and Subdeacon Andrew and I were in the back trying to guess what his name meant. So it means Poly, many. Ectos means desires, wish, or prayers. Polyeuctus. So his name means many wishes or many prayers. A little bit of history or a little bit of trivia there. I'm not sure if I'll remember that for next year, or maybe one of you will. But his name does mean something. It means many desires or prayers or wishes. And I know that the desire of all the saints, and our desire should be to be united with the Holy Trinity who has revealed himself to us so that we might inherit the glory of the kingdom of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to you forever.
We want to welcome our visitors who are with us this evening. You really grace us by your presence. I'd like to invite everyone for liturgy tomorrow morning, hoping that the weather will cooperate, but it's not looking great. As many of you know, the weather reports are calling for freezing rain and ice from 5 a.m. till just about afternoon. Weather people are often wrong, so check the report. But as I put in the email, the best way and the safest way to drive on ice is not to. Okay? So please, be very careful and cautious. I'm actually going to be spending the night at the Annex tonight, so just in case, if no one else can be here, I can at least come and offer prayers at the church. I'll be live streaming those if that happens. If not, we'll see you here tomorrow. We can talk about how weathermen get to be wrong most of the time and still keep their jobs. All right? It's bound to happen, so we'll just see what happens. But God bless you all. Be safe, and we'll see you in the morning. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to you forever.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus.